got TD5 in the Gulf. We have Dean out in the Atlantic.
And we have Flossie over by Hawaii.
In the Pacific, that's right. And luckily, it's weakened even more now, guys. This is now a tropical storm, but nevertheless, lots of rainfall for the Big Island. And look at the surf. I want to show you some video from yesterday in the daylight hours. You can see the waves crashing on up. We're talking 20-foot seas. So big-time erosion and great news for the surfers. You know, those folks are loving it because they're used to it, but certainly not something you want to mess with. Here's a look at Tropical Storm Flossie now on the satellite imagery, and it's just passing south of the Big Island and expected to maintain its storm status as it continues to move northwestward just south of the island chain. Now, we take a look at what's been going on in our forecast. We've got mid to upper 70s most areas except 73 at the Space Center right now as we start the day, so we're running a little warmer than average already this morning. Skies have cleared on out. Thunderstorm activity has moved off to the south and west and dissipated. And I think today, a similar story. We're going to have the sea breeze coming ashore, colliding with the West Coast sea breeze. So Ocala, Leesburg, Claremont, you're going to have a better chance to see any storms than I think, say, Sanford, Kissimmee, and Orlando would, even up toward Palm Coast. But look at the heat. We're talking about mid-90s for the most part, all across the board. Yesterday, we hit a record of 98 at OIA, and today it's still going to be hot, mid to upper 90s across the inland areas. High pressure still back to our west, and this high that's helping to cause the air to heat on up over central Florida is actually going to be building eastward, I think, over the next couple of days. So I don't expect any decrease, significant decrease in the temperatures, even though we're going to be seeing a little bit of a change. I don't think it's going to be significant either way. We're talking flirting with some records here and there. There's the sea breeze for the afternoon. This is where the best chance of rain is for the afternoon today. Then for tomorrow, I think maybe even off to the south of us where the better coverage would be as that moisture just continues to get shunted down to the south. We've got a northeast flow aloft, so any storms that develop generally will be moving off to the south as we go on through the next couple of days. But rain chances, again, 20% or less, very dry for this time of the year. Now, here's a look back at the Gulf again, watching this cluster of thunderstorms over the last 12 hours or so. You can see how it's really blowing on up. Hurricane Hunters did find a closed circulation, and so it was named Tropical Depression 5 late last night. It's moving northwest at 10 toward Corpus Christi. Could be Aaron before it makes landfall there sometime tomorrow with a lot of rain. We're talking 3 to 5 inch widespread rain amounts. Then we get back here toward the central Atlantic. Here's Dean still holding together 50-mile-an-hour sustained winds, fighting off a bit of dry air out there over the Atlantic. And you can see here on the forecast track, as we go west, toward the Antilles as a Category 1 hurricane late Thursday night into Friday, and then somewhere through, say, Dominica, all the way up into the Bahamas, all the way into the Southern Caribbean early next week as a Category 2 or even 3 hurricane. You can see the models all trending on a westward track for now. Here's your 5-day plus 2. Of course, we're going to watch Dean closely, but for now, the big story is just the heat continuing, Danny, with mid-90s just about each and every day.